drove for miles and miles and wound up at your door. I've had you so many times, but somehow I want more. I don't mind spending every day out on your corner in the pouring rain. Look for the girl with the broken smile. Ask her if she wants to stay.
I was able to provide these services. These people are happy. They ate great food. I got amazing workers. It's over and it still is filled with people who are helping clean up. Thank God for these people I know. Yes.
And I know your grandmother, Miss Ella, is looking down on you and she's so very proud of you. And so why did you want to do this event for her?
Just because, like I said, I was in ninth grade when she passed away, going to ninth grade. I was there with her every day. So I saw firsthand everything that happens. She had a breast removed like 4 or 5 years earlier and she still bled out every day. So I was with her going to the hospital. I was with her on her hospice visit. When you are diagnosed with cancer, the first thing to go is your looks. That's the first thing you feel every single cancer survivor we spoke to. First thing to go is your looks. Second thing right after is self-esteem. So today was all about rebuilding these women and their men, their self-esteem, getting them to understand, we see you, you're not alone. You got all these mounting medical bills. So how about enjoy this day on us?